Hey everyone, welcome to the third video on developing applications for the Flipper Zero using scenes and reusable modules. This video is mostly focused on how we fill in the app structure that we created in the previous video, so be sure to watch my other two videos first. I'll add a link in the comments below. We're going to be using an app alloc method that we create, and then we'll also look at how the callbacks delegate their work to the scene manager. At the end of the video, we'll talk briefly about the next video. Reviewing, in the previous video, we talked about creating an enum of our components. We have since learned that those are not called components, but they're called modules, and each module has a view. What we actually want to do is create an enum of those different views. This way, our knob and our widget will be given IDs that we can refer to later. So our enum has app view knob and app view widget. Next, we talked about creating an app scene handlers object that contained our enter handlers, our on event handlers, and our exit handlers, and it also contained how many scenes we have. And finally, we had talked about the structure for the app, which is what we're going to, in this video, be filling out, which had our scene manager, our view dispatcher, our knob and our widget modules, and the data for our application, which in this case was volume and frequency. All right, let's get started. The next few slides are going to talk about the app alloc method that we'll be writing. The goal of this method is to return back that filled out app structure. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to allocate memory that's big enough to hold that app structure. Next, we're going to initialize the data. In this example, we had the frequency and the volume, where it's the data we wanted to set to some default value. Then we wanted to set the scene manager for our app. And for that, we're going to use scene manager alloc. We're going to pass in that app scenes handler we were just talking about that had those on enter, on exit, and on event. We're also going to pass in a reference to this app object. Still in the app alloc method, we're now going to talk about the view dispatcher. We're going to do a view dispatcher alloc to allocate that. Within that view dispatcher, we're also going to call enable queue, passing it the view dispatcher. And then we have a couple of callbacks. We're going to call set event callback context, passing it our view dispatcher and our application. So that's the application context. When it makes callbacks, it will pass to our method. For the custom event callback, we're going to register that it invokes our app scene custom callback. For navigation, which is when the back button gets pressed, we're going to register a callback. So again, to the view dispatcher, we're going to say call our app back event callback. And we'll look at these two callbacks in a couple slides. So now that we've done that, the next piece is to actually create our two components. Our app knob component, we're going to call knobs alloc. That's going to do that initialization. We're going to add a view. We pass in the view dispatcher that's associated with our app, and then we're going to pass in that ID from the enum that we looked at the beginning. And then we're going to pass in our knobs view. So we call app knob, and then knob get view just returns the view associated with that knob. We're going to make a widget as well. So we're going to use the widget module. And so our app widget equals widget alloc, which is going to do all that memory allocation and initialization. And then we're going to tell the view dispatcher about the widget's view. So we're going to say view dispatcher, the ID that we want to talk about for widget, and then we're going to get the widget's view and pass that. So at this point, we've now fully filled out that app structure, and we're going to return the filled in app. So again, at this point, we've set the scene manager, we've set the view dispatcher, we've allocated that knob, we've allocated that widget, and we set these to some default values. The second part of our app alloc with our view dispatcher, we had set our context to be app, and we had registered these two callbacks, app scene custom callback and app back event callback. Let's take a closer look at the callback code. The first callback, app scene custom callback, takes two parameters. The first parameter is the context, and the second parameter is the event ID. We cast the context into the app object, which gives us access to the scene manager. We invoke the scene manager handle custom event, passing the scene manager and that custom event ID. The scene manager will then invoke our current scene's on event method, passing the custom event ID. The second callback is app back event callback. This gets triggered when the back button is pressed. Again, we cast the context into the app object, which gives us access to the scene manager. We invoke scene manager handle back event, passing our scene manager. The scene manager will then change the current scene to the previous scene, and if this is the first scene, our application will exit. That's it for this talk. In our next talk, we're going to talk about our program's entry point code, and then also the scene's on-enter, on-event, on-exit callback code, and how to free resources. And at that point, we should have all the information we need to be able to use scenes in our own application. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. And if you enjoyed this video, please like it and subscribe to the channel. Thanks a lot.